Hi everybody, it's Caroline again, and I'm here to do my January 2012 favorites. This is going to be a little bit of an eclectic favorite thing. I haven't been shopping very much other than my nail polish haul that I just posted a couple of days ago. So I just wanted to just put in my favorites of the month of January, and it's not a lot of makeup, but a couple of things that I got that I purchased in January, and some old favorites that I, since this is, you know, my first favorite video, or my second favorite video actually. But anyways, it's my second favorites video, and I just wanted to put in what I like this month. One of the first things that I want to say is my favorite for this month is I finally got my first women's running magazine. I have been waiting for this magazine for a while because magazines tend to take a while to get to me, I feel, and I was really looking forward to this. I just started training for my second half marathon that I'm doing this year in 2012. My first one was in 2011, and I don't feel that I need that much stuff for running other than obviously good running shoes and what have you, and an iPod because, you know, you have to listen to some music. But I just like the women's running magazine. I'm trying to be healthier. 2012, my New Year's resolution is to get healthier in 2012. I already have accomplished a lot in 2011. So I got out of the army, I kind of stopped working out for a while, and I just want to get back into that healthy, fit lifestyle that I was used to. And that while I may not enjoy the working out process while I'm doing it, I really do enjoy the results. And so I'm trying to get back into that mentality of working out and you know, wanting to do it. So anyways, I got myself the Women's Running Magazine, and this is what this month is. Beginner's Training Guide to Running. Isn't that awesome? Even though I'm not a beginner to running because I did run in the military and I did run my first half marathon last year, I still find it very interesting. There's still things that I need to learn or relearn because I haven't run for a marathon in a long time. And one of the other things that I love is that since it's a woman's running, it also has articles that are beauty and health related, sort of like the Think Pink article here, and it talks about all of these wonderful beauty products that you can use that also help, you know, they put money in for charities that support cancer and breast cancer, and that's always a positive thing to do. My second favorite item for January 2012 is actually a nail file. This is a Revlon glass nail file that I actually got from a coworker of mine. This is what it looks like. And it's a glass nail file. And a glass nail file, what it does, it's really gentle for your nails. So for example, I'm one that I will not cut my nails, but I will file them down. I use a regular, you know, metal nail filer or emery board nail filer to file them down because it takes so much off. And then to get a nice smooth finish, you just use a glass nail file like this, and you get a really smooth finish. You don't get the rough edges and the peel, you know, peeling from doing your nail file with the emery board and what have you. These tend to be really expensive, so I never bought myself one. Even the Revlon one is like $7 or something, but she found them at Walmart for she found them for $2. They were on clearance for $2, and then they put them in that, like, I don't know if all Walmarts have this, but the one we have here, they have like a rack, a whole roll that has everything that they're trying to get rid of, and it's super, super marked down. So she bought herself, I think she said, 7 of these things for $1 each, which before they were 7 something for just one. So that right there, that's a bargain. So I bought myself one from her. I bought two actually. One, this is the one I have and I have actually opened, and there's a second one that I haven't opened and I actually left it at work by accident. But I'm loving these things. They really do make a difference when I do my nails and whatnot. Okay, so the next item is actually a makeup product. There's two items that are my January favorites that are a makeup item. The NYX Eyeshadow Trio in Rock and Roll. And this is what it looks like here. I actually bought myself this when I went to Ulta, and I wanted it because I had seen a video on Emily Noel's channel, Beauty Broadcast, and she had said that these three shadows were dupe for eyeshadows from MAC eyeshadows, and I can't remember which ones they were duped for right now, but I thought, oh, well, that's great. You know, I'm not a big fan of the MAC eyeshadow, the way that they apply and the way that they don't stay on me for a very long time, I feel, but they have beautiful colors, and I wouldn't mind having a dupe, a less expensive dupe of something high end. So I bought myself this, you know, palette right here, and I really have been enjoying it. I've been wearing it to work a lot just because it's very neutral and it still can give you a smoky eye. This color right here, the darker bluish gray one, that is a ridiculously pigmented eyeshadow. Look, that's it. That was one swipe. You guys saw me do it. It's one swipe, and look how pigmented this thing is. The first time that I used it, I didn't realize how pigmented it was gonna be, and I put way too much on my eye, and it was just ridiculous. But I am really enjoying these NYX eyeshadows. In fact, this is my second NYX eyeshadow, NYX product that I've bought, and I am definitely gonna go back for more because I think they're great. They're fabulous. The formula and the consistency and the pigmentation is absolutely fabulous in NYX, and I love that they are drugstore. Although I can only find these in Ulta or cherryculture.com. The next makeup product is the Sheer Cover Dual Concealer that I got from my glam bag. I am actually really loving this right now. This is the color that I got, which is light and medium. I use the eye part for my under eye concealer, like to brighten it up a little bit, and then I put this one on top of it, or my regular concealer on top of it. It seems to work very well for me. I haven't had any problems with it. I've been wearing a lot of powder foundation, I guess, because the liquid foundation that I have right now is a little too dark for me. I don't have the money for it right now to buy a liquid foundation because I'm saving up for my wedding, and this Sheer Duo does a wonderful job to use as a concealer under my powder foundation. I haven't had any problems with it. And finally, for the makeup, is the Urban Decay D-Slick Oil Control Makeup Setting Spray. That is what it looks like. And I got the big bottle. I think it's $14 for a big bottle like this. I could be mistaken. It has been a while. Actually, December. I bought this in December. And I think I'm maybe up to here. I think that's where I am, right there. I love this because I tend to have an oily face, especially in my T-zone right here. And I have noticed, while it doesn't completely stop my face from being oily, it definitely helps control the oiliness. It does not, I don't get as oily as fast. My makeup lasts longer. The little rice paper facial tissues, I don't feel like I have to use those as much, and I really, really love that I don't have to use those as much because they tend to be a little bit expensive. My favorite facial cleanser right now is the Cetaphil Daily Facial Cleanser for normal to oily skin. This is what I have right now. I absolutely love it. I think it's so gentle enough to use for everybody. I have very sensitive face. Ooh, sorry. I have a very sensitive face, and I have very sensitive skin, and I noticed that this helps clear my skin and keep my face clean without drying it out or giving me weird rash or breaks me out because it's too harsh for my skin. And the last product that is in my favorites for this month of January 2012 is Yes to Carrots, the Daily Moisture Lotion. I love the smell of this product. I love the, it leaves my skin feeling really, really soft. Actually, this is the second bottle that I've purchased. I need to go buy more because I'm actually running out. I think it's up to here right now. Yeah. Last time I looked inside, it was up to there. And this smell, I don't even know how to, it's very light smell. Almost sweet, but not really. It doesn't smell chemically, and it doesn't smell like some lotions don't have any kind of smell, but that lotion chemical smell does not smell like this. I really like it. I also love that they're cruelty-free. And they also, they're cruelty-free and mostly organic. I think they say it's 99% natural product. So, and it's paraben-free. So that's it for my January favorites for this month. I hope you guys enjoyed it. Let me know what your favorites are. You can always leave a comment below or press on the like button below if you like this video. I would really appreciate it because it always helps me out. I hope everybody has a great day. Thank you so much for watching. Bye.